penitent one. Our bond led us to victory. But it was not the victory I long for. Is it your wish that I continue with the story of my promise? Indeed, it was the miracle's will that made the bell ring. But it was the lady's sin that brought the curse down upon us. The lady, the most beautiful of women, who lived in the palace by the lake, lived to admire her own beauty, which she believed to be unnaturally divine. The reflection of the lake in which she admired herself returned her own beauty with yet more intensity and splendor, keeping her spellbound for days. Desiring that reflected perfection for herself, she prayed to the lake that no one else might see that reflection. As she looked at her reflection one more time, she saw her face distort to the sound of a terrible tolling that rose up from the lake's sunken bell. Do you wish me to join you in your next confrontation? There you shall find me, and in communion we shall fight.
How dark and uncertain are the rooms where the miracle allows us to see and talk to one another. Even after the deaths. Even after the dreams. Penitent one, we are in the Chapel of the Five Doves. And before you prevails the narrative voice of the witness. All that remains of me is testimony. For my deceased body lies exposed in its urn of crystal and gold. You return from the long dream to avoid the birth. You will have need of the uncorrupted tongue that my mortal remains still harbor, whose forbidden whispers will guide thee on the path to such an undertaking. Release the five doves, and thus the urn containing my body shall be opened. Wake up now from this dream.
penitent one. This is no place for anyone. Can you not see that death breathes the very air that dries our throats? That it walks in our footsteps? You cannot even hear the cries for the dead. For here, even crying is forbidden. I will remain in the shadows, sheltering behind these bars, so you cannot look upon my diseased countenance. But although no one has ever managed to find out who he really is, I can reveal to you a name. Castor. How ominous that name sounds when spoken in these shadowy enclaves. I may have something for you. If so, be sure to take it and go. Do you not notice how death enfolds us and shelters us? Do you not notice how it dries up the very tears in our eyes? It is my prison, my companion, my guardian. For all that is dead accompanies me, and all that is not yet dead will soon die and wither by my side. What sins did I commit to merit such a heavy penance? You have acquired the last of my goods. However, we never know when the miracle will bestow new blessings upon us. I am the ruin of what I once was, cursed with the ever more bitter need to survive. I ended up stealing in the foulest of ways. I stole from the rich. I stole from the poor. I even stole from the dead. What crime can there be in taking possession of what no longer has a master? Leave me alone. I feel something devouring me inside, like flies swarming over a dead body. And so it was that I managed to get into a house that appeared to be uninhabited. Inside, I found an elderly woman lying on her bed. She had been dead for some time. There was no one standing vigil over her. She was alone. Alone in the deep sleep of death. The fearful stench was so intense that it seemed to emanate from that rigid body and mingle with the light that drifted in through the immaculately pale curtains from the outside street lamps, creating the most dismal of atmospheres I had ever experienced. It was the chamber of death itself. Oh, death, who is ever by my side, you will not have to wait much longer. I robbed the old woman in her bed. I took from her what was no longer hers, but rather belonged to death itself. When I reached my hiding place, I was racked with terrible pangs of guilt that have not ceased to intensify and ever torment my body and mind. What is this trembling you bring me, O death? What is this coldness that I feel both inside and out? Doth thee already seek me? Oh, so much death all around me. So many maggots creeping over so many dead bodies immersed in the mire. So many flies announce the arrival of the rotting queen with their mournful dances and incessant buzzing. For now, there is nothing more for you among my goods. But the miracle is merciful, and we never know when it will bestow new blessings upon us.
Thank you. Thank you.
penitent one. Be pleased to receive this gift that a candid voice in a dream asked me to give thee. A voice whose owner shall always be unknown to me. O heart that descends from heaven, what doth thou seeketh from us?
The miracle shows us mercy, and bestows upon this shadow the right to speak. Never will I comprehend for what exalted reasons I was chosen to witness and narrate the events by which the miracle sought to return to us. For many eons have passed since it abandoned us. Oh, I see my request was granted, and that blessed pilgrim delivered my offering to you. Cast open the cages whose keys were stolen. Dove, who borrows thine color from the raven, escape your gilded prison.
Now I shall enhance the vital light within thee. I shall wait for thee to bring me more chalices. With this crystal, I mark and imbue thy flasks with silver and bile. Only the miracle shall know how many crystals have been bathed in its grace. Bring me chalices and vials, and I shall fill them with mine own blood.
The file you bring is able to polish wood and leave it as smooth as the petals of dried flowers. Know that you have my gratitude, penitent one. Behold these beautiful oil paintings with colors that radiate life itself. Know that you have my gratitude, penitent one. Allow me to present you with a new piece for your silver altarpiece. May the hands of the miracle guide thee, penitent one.